Welcome to the fun field, action packed geology assignment for 3203. What we're going to talk about today is some of the intro work that you might do before you go to site, just so you can maximize the value of what you're going to get when you're out there. The first component of the site is Bronte. So one of the things we need to do as geotechnical engineers is to collect field information in a standardized way that allows us to develop models of what we expect the subsurface conditions to be, and also to assign properties to the soil and rock that we encounter. The purpose of this Bronte component of the assignment is to allow you to actually experience the process of collecting that data for rock engineering. In this video, I'll just discuss what you might do prior to going out and actually collecting that data. When we're doing any geotechnical engineering work, as we're never actually going to see a full exposure of the soil or rock until it possibly falls down and then it's too late, we always work off a geotechnical model. You can consider that model as being an educated guess as to what we expect to be at the site. As we learn more information, the model is continually updated throughout that whole project. So we learn more and more about the geological conditions, we can add that to our model. The first model, the first component of our model, is done prior to going to the site, and it's called the preliminary geological model. This model allows us to have a prediction of what we might expect at the site. Its job is to highlight any potential issues we might encounter that might impact on our particular engineering project. This allows us to focus on what matters when we get to site, and we can ignore other things. As we don't have any prior experience to going to our site, our main source of information is going to be the appropriate geology map. In this case, the map we will use is the Wonder 100,000 Sydney geological map. In most locations, the geology map is going to tell us what the near surface rock type is. However, where you've got really deep soils, it will give you the surface soil type. The map also provides you with some limited cross sections and some valuable descriptions of the rock type and the age of the rock type. If we focus on our Bronte site, we can observe that the site's dominated by RH Hawkesbury sandstone. The map tells us this is a quartz sandstone with occasional lenses of thin beds of shale. To the north, there are sands indicated. They're probably the beach. To the south, there's black lines on the map. Those black lines are dikes. Now note that these are to the north and south of the site. They're not at the site, so we would not include the beach nor the dikes in our preliminary model. Also note, the Hawkesbury sandstone is approximately 250 metres thick. So that's well beyond the limit of any civil engineering project. So as far as our model's concerned, we don't worry about what's beneath our sandstone layer. What I want you to do is to do some of your own research. Research the properties of the Hawkesbury sandstone, including the intact rock, the substance, and the expected defects that you might encounter in Hawkesbury sandstone. I'd also like you to think about what soils might lie on top of the sandstone. You need to support your ideas, so explain your thinking, give some references. In our second part of our assignment, what you're going to do is go on a self-guided field trip. So what I want you to be doing is seeing real soils and real rocks. In the classroom, we're seeing lecture rocks, lecture soil. I've traveled the world to try and find you the best pictures. It's been very difficult for me. But in engineering, we usually see weathered rock, eroded soil, etc. So you need practice at looking for those things. So this assignment is all about that. It's a good idea, as we do with Bronte, to create a preliminary model before you go to the site to maximize the value of your time at the site. If you look at the North Bondi option for a field trip, we can see that the site's north of Bondi Beach. We go to the geology map and we can see the rock type, like Bronte, is dominated by Hawkesbury sandstone, that RH material. In this case, however, it's intruded by a JV volcanic neck. So the volcanic necks come up through the sandstone. And that contains, according to the geology map, volcanic breccia and basalt. The geology map also shows us a dike running parallel to the coast along our site and three perpendicular to the coast in the vicinity of our site. So we need to consider looking for those. So prior to going to the site, you should think about what effects the volcanic neck might have on the sandstone around it. Also do a bit of research on what the dikes in Sydney typically look like. So again, once you're out there, you've got a good idea of what you're looking for, increases your chances of finding things. The Piemont excursion option covers most of Piemont. And if we look at the geology map for Piemont, shows again the areas underlain by Hawkesbury sandstone, the same as Bondi and Bronte. There's also a north-south trending dike running right through the middle of Piemont, so we'll keep our eyes out for that when we're walking around. We can also see to the northeast there's a section of reclaimed land connecting to the harbour. We won't see that on our field trip, but it's always good to note that that is at the site. If you go and do the Long Reef site, you're going to see quite different rocks. And this is because the rocks at the site are much older than the rocks at the other sites. So being older, these are the rocks that would be underneath the Hawkesbury sandstone, essentially 250 metres below Bronte, for example. The geology map for Long Reef suggests that the majority of the site we'll be walking around that forms the headland and the rock platform we walk on is RNBH Bald Hill Claystone. This comprises, according to the geology map at least, red shale and fine to medium sandstone. There's a small exposure on the map of RNN Newport Formation, and that's to the north of the site. Now the Newport Formation, apparently, comprises inter-bedded shale and sandstone. It's a younger unit than the Bald Hill Claystone, so you'd expect it to be above the Bald Hill Claystone. So if we're looking at it on site, it's got to be at the higher elevations, somewhere where it hasn't eroded previously. At the very eastern tip of the site, so on, off the rock platform, we can see there is RNBU Bolgo sandstone. And this comprises sandstone with shale interbeds within it. This rock is the oldest unit at the site, and it's found beneath the Bald Hill Claystone. So it's the layer underneath that claystone. The geology map shows that on the western half of the site, it sits on marine sand, so the yellow area. This is an area, it was probably a river channel, so it eroded through the rock. And then as the sea level rose from the last ice age, it would have been infilled with sand. When we're developing our preliminary model, we'd like as much information as we can. So we'll often look at aerial photographs to see if we can observe other features. One of the things we can look for are lineaments or straight lines. Lineaments are unusual in natural topography. Nature likes curves. And so if we see lineaments, they might often indicate things like joints, fault lines, might be areas where there's landsliding, or it might indicate dikes. If we have a look at the aerial photograph for Long Reef, we zoom in, have a look at that, particularly on the rock platforms, we can see there's a number of lineaments cutting across, in particular, the rock platform. Some of these seem to also control the shape, so the rock platform actually cuts in along those lineaments. So put that in your head, put it in your preliminary model. All right, there's the lineaments where they are. So when you go to site, you can try and locate them and try and identify what they are. Are they faults, are they dikes, or are they just a line on a map? Okay, so that's all from me. The rest is up to you. Make sure you do some of your own research before going to site. Don't just believe me. Make sure you're well prepared for what you might find. Remember to enjoy yourselves, definitely stay safe, and I hope you learn some useful things. See you back in class.